God. We are overcomers, my God. We are overcomers, Jesus. We are overcomers, God. We worship you. We are overcomers. We must overcome every problem. We must overcome sickness and the diseases. We must overcome every problem. We must overcome every stronghold. We must overcome everything that is rising up against us. In the name of Jesus, my God, my Father, in the name of Jesus, we must overcome the powers of darkness. In the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, I thank you, my God. My Father, we need a miracle. We need a life miracle. We need a speed miracle. In the name of Jesus, we need miracle, Jesus. Miracle, Jesus, Jesus. Son of the living God, we give our life to you, Jesus. We love you and we worship you, God. We are come before your presence, before you, to honor you, Lord, once again, my God, my Father. In the name of Jesus. Oh, yes, Lord, I thank you. We give all the glory. Lord, my Father, I bind and cast out every works of the enemy, every powers and rulers of darkness. I silence them by fire. I silence them by thunder. I silence them by the power in the blood of Jesus. My God, I want to thank you once again. Thank you, my God. I bring the people of Periscope, all our family, friends, and the other people that are following us. Lord, I bring them to you, my God. I thank you for their life, God. I praise your name for their life, Lord. I pray, God, my Father, everyone that is looking for a miracle, everyone that needs their life to change, everyone that you know their needs, God, my Father, I pray that God, my God, give them. Bless them, God, my Father. Let them receive their miracle this morning. This time, I don't know your time in your country, but here in Canada, it's in the morning. But Lord, we call upon you, Father. We know that, God, you are able to deliver us, God. You are able to answer our prayers. You are able, Lord, to meet our needs according to your riches and glory, God. We love you, Jesus. We give you all the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen, amen, amen. Thank you very much. Welcome, everyone. Welcome, friends. Thank you for joining. Thank you. Thank you for inviting your friends. Thank you. Thank you. God bless you so much. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you so much. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Yes. As I'm going to talk to you, the title of this prayer is called Prayers That Must Change Life and Bring Miracles. Prayers that must change life and bring miracles. We need miracles. You've been in a problem. You have been praying for a long time. Therefore, today, as we are going to pray, it is prayer. It is prayers. It is prayer that will change. Prayer must change life. Prayer must change life. Prayer must bring miracles. We need miracles. We need miracles. We've been in circle. We've been circle ourselves. We've been circle so many. We have been living in stagnation. We've been living in circle for all the time, for so long. Therefore, it's the time to come out, and God will open ways for you, and God will bless you, in Jesus' name. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isigi, welcome you from Overcomers Deliverance and Healing Ministry, Brampton, Ontario, Canada. Welcome once again. Yesterday, I mentioned that we would have prayers for singles today, tonight, starting from midnight tonight. So I got so many phone calls last night. People, I don't know, they didn't understand that we are starting Thursday night. We will start in midnight Thursday. Today, midnight, we'll start the prayer for singles. Singles, enough is enough. You've been single for a long time. Your time has, the time is up now to seek your partner. To seek your partner, and it is through prayers that you will get the right person. When you go to God, God will bring a partner to you. So even those one who are engaged, who wants to get married, you are welcome to join, because you have to really to get this person, is it from God or from the devil or from the enemy? Because you can get a partner who loves you so much, loves you the first 3 months, 1 year, and then the second year is something else. It will throw you out and change and divorce and make your life too miserable. So it's better that you seek God to give you the right lifetime partner. That word by the devil will not have any access, any legal to accuse you or to bring divorce. I pray that you will join us. And if you want to learn more about this, you are welcome to join us. And we will be having deliverance, women deliverance. We will be having so many prayers, 3 days prayer and fasting. We'll seek our God. So if you are in medication, you don't have to fast, just let us know. Send your name, send prayer request. We will pray for you. We will fast for you. And if you can be able to pray from 6 to 6, welcome. If you can pray at 12 o'clock, you are also welcome. Because some people, they can't take long time. Maybe it's your first time to pray and fast. So I could recommend you that you can start from midnight to 12 o'clock. And then you can drink water, you can just take light food, small amount of food. Then you continue prayer because you are not used with this. So and if you can be able to fast, dry fasting, go ahead and do that. But if you can't, because it depends on how you take it. So if you cannot, just get something small, literally small amount, and keep on praying. We will be praying so much, and we will use our prayer line. Maybe I will not be using Periscope a lot because there's a lot of destruction in Periscope, but I will be using prayer line. And if you don't have a long distance, you can always get Skype. Skype is there. You can get us. And all you can, I will see if I can tune Ustream, but mostly I could prefer prayer line. Prayer line is when everybody will be crying to God, praying to God. So our prayer line number is 712-77-57085. Those who are writing for me, please, can you pull that number? I don't know if Deborah is there or someone else can volunteer to do that. I know Treasure is coming, it will be late. But if you are there and you can catch this number, please, can you write it so that the people can see? It's 712-775-7085. This is the number. This is the number that the prayer line. And the access code number is 595119. So when you call this, you will come in and join the prayer at midnight, 12 midnight today. So God bless you. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Prayers that must change life and bring miracles. Prayers that must change life and bring miracles. This is what we are going to talk about. Prayers that must change life and bring miracles. And I'm going to read from the book of Acts 4 verse 23. I would like my sister Anita to read for us. Welcome, my sister.
And being let go, thank you.
Yes.
They went to their own company and reported all that the chief priests and the elders had said unto them. And when they heard that, they lifted up their voice to God with one accord, and said, Lord, thou art God, which hath made heaven and earth, and the sea, and all that is in them is. Amen.
Continue up to 31.
Who by the mouth of thy servant David hath said, Why did the heaven rage, and the people imagine vain things? The kings of the earth stood up, and the rulers were gathered together against the Lord, and against his Christ. of the truth against thy holy child Jesus, whom thou hast anointed both Herod and Pontius Pilate, with the Gentiles and the people of Israel, were gathered together. For to do whatsoever they had their hand and thou counsel, determined before to be done. And now, Lord, behold, thou threaten and grant unto thy servants that with all boldness they may speak thy word, by stretching forth thine hand to heal, and that signs and wonders may be done by the name of the holy child Jesus. Amen.
Amen. At 31.
And when they had prayed, the place was shaken where they were assembled together, and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost, and they spake the word of God with boldness.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, sister. Now, here is Apostle Peter and John. They were told that they should not preach, they should not pray. They were arrested. But now, according to the word of God, the Bible says, and being let go, they went to their own companions and reported all that the chief priests and elders had said to them. So when they heard that, they raised their voice to God with one accord and said, you know, they raised their voice in one accord and they said, that's why we need to be together to pray to God. If we need a miracle, the Bible says, where two or three are gathered, is there in the midst. Now the apostles, when they heard what they were saying, they come together and raised up the voice to God with one accord and said, Lord, you are God who made heaven and earth, and the sea and all that is in them, who by the mouth of your servant David has said. So they prayed and tell God, God, you are the Lord who made heaven, earth, and the sea. You are God who made heaven and earth and the sea. You are God who by the mouth of your servant David have said, why do the nation rage and the people profane things? The kings of the earth took their stand against the rulers and gathered together against the Lord and against his Christ. Why? They were asking, you know this. Why, God? Why is it that the rulers, satanic kings, satanic priests, wicked people, they are taking advantage of Christians? They are taking advantage of you. Witchcraft, they are taking advantage of you. They take advantage and destroy your life. They program things against you. They prayed. Why is it that the witchcraft can be have power to do witches and make your life miserable? To send sickness and it affect you? What? Why? You are a God of everything. You are a God who created heaven and earth. You are a God who created even the sea. Now the sea that we need to enjoy, witchcraft is owning the sea. They own the water. They say the water belongs to them. The disciples were mad. They were mad. They prayed until their life must change. The miracle must happen. They were very bitter. And they prayed very aggressive prayers. That is why we need to pray. You must be angry in your spirit. As we will start the prayer, you will be praying like a mad wounded lion. Or like lion wounded. Yes. Like mad prophet. We pray like mad prophet. So you must be very angry in your spirit because you cannot live this life. You've been struggling so much. You have been praying, nothing is happening. You must change your prayers. You must change it to spiritual warfare prayers. That's when you use fire, thunder, lightning, the name of Jesus, like what the disciples did here. For truly, For truly against your holy servant Jesus, whom you anointed, both Herod and Potiphar, believed with the Gentiles and the people of Israel were gathered together to do with whatever your hand and done. So the prone and disgraced Jesus, whom he was anointed, these people, they were able to do that to Jesus. Now they wanted to also destroy Peter and John. They were warned not to preach, not to say any word. They were warned. But Peter said, we cannot listen to you. We better listen to God than you. Very aggressive. Now look, Lord. Here is, now they are representing their case to God. Look, they said, now, Lord, look on their threats and grant to your servants that with all boldness that may speak your word by switching out your hand to heal, and that signs and wonders may be done. You see now, they are representing their case to God. They reported their case, their petition to God. They said, God, they said, now, Lord, look on their threats. Now, Lord, look the situation that I am. Now, Lord, look that I've been single for all these years. That, Lord, look, I have no job. Lord, look that my children are scattered. Lord, look, my marriage is scattered. Lord, look and see. Now, after they pray like that, the Bible says, hallelujah. After they prayed that prayer point, they raised a very powerful prayer point to the throne of God. First of all, they told God that God, you are everything. You are the owner of this world. You created the heaven and you created the sea and everything living here. You have power. We believe in you. We have seen your hand. We come before you now. We want to see you. Look at this, the threatening of the enemies. Enemy has been threatening you enough. You've been engaged. They have locked you in a box. Enemies have terrorized you. They have molested you. You have been suffered so much in the hands of the enemy. Now here is the enemy that is threatening you, wants to kill you, wants to destroy your children, wants to take away your marriage. You've been single for all this long time. And the enemy is happy looking at you, saying that you suffer. Now, after the prayer, look at verse 31. After they prayed, what happened? Instant, something happened. And when they had prayed, the place where they were assembled together was shaken, and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost, and they spoke the word of God with boldness. Now, here is the disciples of Jesus. Remember, the disciples of Jesus, including Peter and the rest of the disciples, during the day of Pentecost, they were filled with the Holy Ghost. They were filled with the Holy Ghost, and they were able to speak in tongues, in different tongues. Now here, again, they wanted to refresh again because they feel that the Holy Ghost that they received, it was not enough. Again, they pray God to get more. That's why prayer is very important. Now, sometimes you feel you are down. You need revival. You need more Spirit of God. You need the Spirit of God to empower you. It's like a car taking to the service, and you service your car, the car will drive, you will drive good. But if you don't take your car to the service, then the car can reject you. So that is how they were. When the disciples of Jesus, Apostle Paul, Peter, and John, when they prayed according to the Bible, they said they were in one accord. No one was different spirit. They prayed, they come together, and they started praying. And the Bible says the place was shaken. I remember one time in Africa, when I was there, we come together, we were seeking the face of God. We prayed, for honestly speaking, the place where we were shaken and we saw the hand of God. We saw miracles happen. The same God is the same God even here in Canada. It's the same God even in your country where you live. It's the same God. That God, we have to call him. He must come to us and perform miracles. Our life must change. We've been in trouble. We've been suffering enough. You cannot live with sickness, child of God, and you are serving Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. You cannot live in poverty, children of God, and our Father is the owner of silver and gold. You cannot be jobless, and our God is the owner of all jobs in the world. Remember, the Bible says that he is the owner of who created heaven and earth and the seas. So you cannot in that situation, and our God is in the throne. You must ask God. You must pray until things change in your life. Things must change in the name of Jesus. The prayer that must change your life. You cannot live anymore that life anymore. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, you have to stand against the powers of darkness that is holding you. Every soul tie against you will break them. Every soul tie and a covenant against you. Any covenant that is holding you, any soul tie that is holding you, any strong man, stronghold that is holding you that you cannot move forward, it shall be destroyed in Jesus' name. You have to come to the point where you say enough is enough. We have heard this gospel all the time. Now we take a step of faith where we say enough is enough. The prayers that must change life and bring miracles. You must change your prayers. You must change where you are in the name of Jesus Christ. Change must change life and bring miracles. Prayer must change life and bring miracles. We've been traditionally praying in a different prayers, but we need the prayers that move mountains. We need the prayer that would change your life in the name of Jesus Christ. Enough is enough. Enough is enough. It is time, your time is up, that you will focus the prayers that must bring miracles in the name of Jesus. If the disciples were praying until the place, the Bible says they prayed until the place was shaken and they were filled with the Holy Ghost, and every one of them were filled and they were empowered in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. When they raised up their voice, they were not joking. They were not joking. That's why, as we are going to start prayer tonight, we are not going to joke. I would ask you to participate. Come and join us. Call that number. I will be in Periscope, and I will see how it will work. So if you don't have long distance, we will be in Periscope. But Periscope, if it will work, that's fine. But prayer line, it will be very important for you to go and join prayer line. You can buy the card for now, the next 3 days, or you can go to, I will be on Periscope, but I don't know how long it will take. But we want to pray. We want to seek God. God has said that it is not good for a man to live alone. And you have been single for so long. It is high time for you. Now that the prayer that must change your life for a miracle. You need a miracle. You need a miracle. You have been praying for so long. You have been sick. That sick does not want to go. You've been tormented. The devil has made you like his own house. The Bible says that he comes back and says, let me go back to my house. He calls your body his house. No, he comes now to torture you, to make your life miserable. People are suffering. People have pain. They don't sleep. They cry day and night. That is not your portion. Jesus Christ is Lord. He's going to deliver you. Maybe you are looking for financial miracle. Our God is a miracle maker. He will provide your ways. He doesn't lie. My God will provide your needs according to his riches. He doesn't lie. When Paul was preaching, he was telling the Philippians, God is going to provide all the your needs according to your riches and according to the riches of glory. Because our God is so rich that you are children of God, you don't have to go like that. He is able. In the name of Jesus, I pray that God will deliver you. God will deliver your ways. Everything that you are looking, the Lord will meet your needs. In the name of Jesus, we pray that God will deliver you. Let's pray. Our Father in heaven, God my Father, I pray that God, you will deliver your people. My God, my Father, you know their needs. You know what they are looking for. Everyone that is seeking you for help, anyone that is looking for a job, those people are looking for healing, God. Their mind has been tortured. Their mind has been damaged. My God, my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray that, oh my God, deliver them. Heal their head. Heal their minds in the mighty name of Jesus. Anyone that is going through some tough stuff, things that is not working for them. Father God, my God, I frustrate them. I bind them and I cast them in Jesus' name. I pray by the power in the blood of Jesus, by the fire of God, let every problem that you are facing today be dismantled, be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I am praying for your children. I am praying for your husband. I'm praying for your wife. I'm praying that God Almighty, any power that is making you to cry, that is making you sad, let them be destroyed. I pray that God Almighty, restoration, bring these people unity together, Father, in the name of Jesus. My God and my Father God, in the name of Jesus, husband who have run away from home and goes to live with strange women, Lord, my Father, I pray those strange women, let them start fighting themselves. Let them be scattered and give away. Let your husband come home. A woman has run away and go to live with other men. My God and my Father, I am calling these people to come back home. Wherever who has run away because of the powers of darkness, they have chased them away. They have chased them from their matrimonial home. Now they are wandering in the wilderness. They are going to the strange husband, strange women. Lord, I destroy them. I pray that let them start fighting themselves in the name of Jesus Christ. My God and my Father, I pray for financial miracle. Wherever who is looking for financial miracle, my God, my Father, let them meet their miracle. Let them receive financial miracle in the name of Jesus. Oh God, my Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray that anyone who is having trouble for workplace, that the place of work, or having troubles with the managers, with their bosses, my God, my Father, in the name of Jesus, as I pray this morning, I pray that God Almighty, look at their threaten. That the way the Bible says, my God, my Father, this is what they said. When they raise up their voice, they said, Lord, look at their threatening. They possess your place of work. Lord, I represent that place into your hand. I pray, Lord, look at their threatening. Some managers, they give you hard life. They want to fire you. We represent this case to them, to our Father. My Father, look at their threatening. By the power in the blood of Jesus, by the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, my Father, let them be destroyed. Let them be removed from that office in the name of Jesus. Wherever is choking with the child of God, as we pray these prayers, the Lord will catch them. The power of God will catch them in the mighty name of Jesus. Every work of the devil, every powers of darkness that is working against you, I am commanding them to be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Any witch, any witchcraft, any powers of witchcraft that is working against your life, that is tormenting you, that is working against you, I destroy them, I bind them, I render them powerless. The Bible says, "Suffer not a witch to live." Therefore, any work of witchcraft, I destroy them in the name of Jesus. I render them powerless. They will not manifest. They will not stand in the name of Jesus. Father, I want to thank you. I thank you, Lord, because you are God. There is no one like you. Thank you, treasure. Thank you. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. My Heavenly Father, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, we pray that God, you will meet our needs according to your riches and glory. In the name of Jesus, any power that is holding your blessings, that does not want your blessings to come out, they are holding so tight. I am bringing the fire of God to burn them to ashes. In the name of Jesus, the land that we need to sell, that the enemy is holding, that piece of land that they doesn't want to go, the house you want to sell, the enemy is holding that the house that must go. I pray that God bring the buyer speedily in the name of Jesus. Any business that you want to do, the enemy is holding that business. I command that business to blow and get out in the name of Jesus. I pray for clients. I pray for customers to come and buy your stuff in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. My God and my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, I want to thank you, Father. I honor you, God. I glorify your name. You are a wonderful, you are a worthy God. In the name of Jesus, I am sending the fire of God to go to every corner of the world and burn to ashes any power of darkness, anyone that is working against you, any child of the devil chanting and spelling against you. Let the fire of God burn them to ashes in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus, I am now praying for your ATM card, your Visa card. I pray for your Visa card. My Father and my God, I bring this Visa card into your hand. I wash them with the blood of Jesus. I bring the book, the bank book into your hand. I bring the keys of the car. I wash them in Jesus' name. I pray that God, in that house you are living, any demon that is hiding anywhere there, I am sending the fire of God to burn them, to set them ablaze, and get them to get out in that house in Jesus' name. Anything that is working against you with Satan, I destroy them by the power in the blood of Jesus. My Father and my God, I pray that God will meet your needs in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you very much. God bless you so much. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isigi, saying bye-bye to you. God bless you. Remember, tonight we are starting prayer and fasting for 3 days for singles. If you are a single, if you are engaged, if you are looking for a partner, this is the time that you have to sacrifice. We have to come to one accord and pray together. The Lord Almighty will see you through. This year, it will not end without being married. We are going to have weddings from next month, June. Weddings upon weddings is coming. Many of you are going to get married by the end of December. December, you will be. That is when many of you will be having weddings. God has answered you. You must get married. You cannot live all of this. You are 30, 40 years, 50, no husband. Some of you have never been married. That is a lie. I am praying that God will give you your husband wherever he is. God will give you your wife wherever he is. You need to have children. You need to have a partner. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. My God, I want to thank you. Praise be the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I pray that God, you cannot live with sickness in your body, that our Lord Jesus Christ is alive. Therefore, people of God, we would stand and pray that God will deliver each and everyone, will meet your needs according to his riches and glory in Jesus' name. Go to our website, www.overcomersdhministries.blogspot.ca. Also, you can reach us by calling this number, 905-487-7196. Also, we have free number, 877-241-3420, extension 101. You will reach us. Thank you, Treasure Deborah. Thank you for pulling those number. God will help you. So, and the prayer line is 712-775-7085. Access code number is 595119. We want to pray one accord. We want to pray in the prayer. I want to hear the voice, people crying to God, people praying to God. And we will have some prayers that will guide us. So call me. If you cannot fast, if you are going to participate, you are most welcome. If you cannot be able to fast, let us know. We will mention your name. Send your prayer request. If you need us to pray for you or you have other needs, email me. Our email is overcomersdhm@gmail.com. Deborah, my sister, just pull that email so that people can send their, or you can text, you can send your text message. Our number, our cell phone number is 647-608-5207. Send your prayer request. If you need me to pray special prayer, tonight we are going to pray, so you can send your prayer request. I will be praying and lift them. Look at what these people were praying. They lift their prayers up. They said, look at this, they are threatening. So we represent your case to heaven tonight for 3 days. You will receive. By the time we finish this prayer, you will be surprised. We will be praying a lot. So every midnight, 12 midnight, we will be praying. Then I will come out, I will come Periscope during the day, and other times I will be on to pray. So we will be praying, but specifically midnight, 12 midnight. It doesn't matter in your country what the time is, but join us. Whether your time is different from here, but God is the same. So join us and let's pray. In the name of Jesus, God will deliver you. Thank you very much. God bless you and have a wonderful time. Bye-bye. Bye.